Hello guys, this is your G.
Turn up the game.
In this episode, we'll show you if the invader is the best defender or not.
Let's go! The newest super player, Bertini the Invader, is not a good striker.
And he cannot stop the freaking bulldozer.
But who can stop the bulldozer, Madeline, except for the other bulldozer?
Only the other? Of course, exactly. It's obvious.
But this episode is about Bertini the Invader as a defender, and we, by mistake, we realized that actually Bertini as a defender is amazingly good. So I don't know actually if the intruder, the invader, or the voyager can be crowned as the kings of the defense. So for that reason, I'm going to play here with my friend Madeline, with formations with four defenders, and we will have both the Voyager and Bertini in defense, and we will say our opinion objectively about who of them is the best. After that, we will play in the arena, of course, in the Infinity Arena, because people came here to watch top plays by CRG, and we will show this to them. Madeline, invite me, please.
Yes.
Okay, we are on Madeline.
Let's see.
What is your defense? Are you... I'm using 43.
Yes.
What about you?
I'm using 4, 1, 2, 3. So in my defense, I'm using the Voyager and the Invader in the central, as you mentioned previously. And I'm using the Marksman on the left side and the Protector on the right side. Look at my Protector.
I'm actually using a Protector and the Warrior on each of the sides from my point, look, Major in defense.
Major
is OP. In the middle, sorry, he's in the middle because I want my middle players to pass from the first touch. And let's test the Jet. I haven't played the Jet in a while because I was mad at him. And will he prove me wrong?
It was the Voyager there. Unfortunately. And I saved the penalty!
But that's it, Madeline. Why are you so happy? Because I have my Major in attack here. Look.
Don't... Oh my god, the Major
don't
is what? There.
Don't what? Wolfgang, the Major! See!
I have to mention, guys, that there are moments when my Invader is there and saves my ass, but not every time.
So. I will try not to score anymore because the idea is to test whether the Invader is better than the Voyager. So let's try them out. I will try not to pressure you. To send the long pass or send the header or across in the box or something, and let's test these two guys.
Okay.
The Voyager,
look at this one for the intruder.
Yes, but there's my Warrior. My Warrior is so
nice
OP.
Yes.
And now let's test Bertini. Where is Bertini? Bertini? Let's test Bertini. Let's see if Bertini will lose the ball because the Voyager usually loses the ball in defense, but Bertini makes a really good run.
I would say
he made a really good run. So
he
cannot
to be more constant than the Voyager regarding this type of moments.
Right. And let's pass to him again. I shouldn't have passed it there because your intruder was there, but I was wrong. What are you doing? You giving me the ball back?
I was trying to. Yes,
okay,
exactly.
Thank you. Thank you. Unfortunately, Bertini is not free, but I will pass it to my Protector and let's pass it to Bertini. Look at my Protector here, guys. What the heck? Where does my Protector want to pass it to? Because this guy is in offside. This is,
really,
why,
but
this is why
yeah,
I don't like the jet,
jet
anymore, guys. This is why I don't like the jet anymore.
Okay, so let me exactly like this.
Nice.
I will pass it to the hammer and I will try to pass it to the intruder on the other side again.
Okay.
Well,
I don't have a Voyager there. I have my Warrior. But it seems like my Warrior is actually always kicking your intruder's ass. What's happening
what
with
was
the
that
today?
Missed? Hey, Mr. Intruder, what is going on?
Again to Bertini. Let's see. Let's see. Bertini in defense. Will he lose it? Because I don't trust my Voyager at all, really. But this intruder seems to be a lot smarter. And let's check this pass from the invader to the intruder. But your Protector is having the marking ability, so I can't stop him.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's try a long pass to your striker and see if the intruder can actually catch up to him.
Okay,
I will not defend.
Hammer, okay. And now... a long pass to my intruder. Let's see the invader there.
And let's see the invader. Who's that? Who's that guy? Who's that guy?
The Voyager.
King, still. King. But Bertini.
Yeah.
Okay, bad pass from my side. Let's test again the Voyager. Voyager. King. He is king. He cannot be.
Yes.
I mean,
yes.
You can't take the crown away from him. And look at the positioning of the Voyager versus the positioning of the Invader. Have you seen that actually? That the Invader didn't mark my strikers correctly, right, Madeline? Was it only my assumption?
No. It's correct what I was saying there. But look at you trying to send a long pass to the Poacher there.
Poacher. Unbelievable. Yes. I'm on a losing streak. What the heck is happening? Because my players should have...
Okay, let me try to pass it to the invader
whatever.
Right now.
And let's see if he loses. He does seem to lose the ball as much as the Voyager does.
Yes.
That's 1 point for the invader. But regarding the marking, let's...
Look at the Voyager.
Yes,
Come on, this episode is about invader.
I will give you the ball back and try to force now my invader. Pass it in the direction of my invader. And let's see if he makes a tackle or not. Yes, he did it.
Oh, nice.
So tackles, yes. I would say, is more or less the same. But positioning is Voyager top. But regarding the trust in defense, I would say that I would trust the invader more than the Voyager. He doesn't seem to lose that many balls. Who's this? Invader?
My protector.
Invader.
No, the invader.
I told you that.
Oh my god,
when it comes,
so fast.
When it comes to running and getting the ball back, they are both really good. But when it comes to positioning, it's the Voyager top, I would say. Okay, Madeline, I will play a game in the arena. So in the first episode, ladies and gentlemen, of course my Voyager was better than the invader because he has the marking ability. But what we want to show you is that the invader is actually a really good defender. And for that reason, Madeline, I will take out Patrizio from the team.
Okay.
I will place my major in defense and I will place a commander in the middle. And I will have only Bertini to be the fast defender. And let's see how he behaves in an arena match.
Okay, you have to go and try to test it. I'm able to see that you're not using the freaking bulldozer.
I don't like
you are still preferring to play with the poacher there and with intruder and with jet. I hope this strategy will help you.
The bulldozer is one of the best players in the game, if not the best player in the game from my point of view. But I really don't want to use a player that is so unreal. I love football. I've played football. I still play football. I hate the freaking bulldozer. This is not something that you have in a football match. Look at Bertini. He passes from the first touch. Really good, Bertini.
It's depending about that because I was able to see a lot of comments regarding our previous episode about that comparison between super players and real football players. And bulldozer was compared with Zlatan Ibrahimovic.
No, Zlatan is
on fire. So.
Zlatan has the skill of a wizard. He has the shots of the marksman. You can't compare him to the bulldozer who only shoots powerfully and he only hits it with the head. Like, you cannot do that. Really nice pass from my opponent. Who's there? I want to know the major. The freaking major was there.
Nice.
The major. Okay. I don't like the jet at all. He has no brains, the jet. Right, Madeline?
Yes.
He has no brains.
In the last days, it was very difficult to play
with
the jet.
Look at him not running anywhere. But what are you doing,
you
jet?
You can try to force it because it's your only chance.
Maybe. No, he has no brain. He's like,
come on.
There's absolutely no brain. And let's test now the... you see how there's a hole in my defense because the invader doesn't have the marking ability. His advantage is that he can run back and get the ball, but he doesn't really mark the people down, which is, from my point of view, a good thing if you don't have the Voyager. But if you have the Voyager, Bertini is dead, from my point of view. Look at Bertini
now.
Let's test this.
Let's see. Such a long pass to your intruder, which will be able to shoot and
to my intruder.
Or from there.
Invader, intruder, Bertini, Jebe, combo. I'm happy. I don't want to win this game. I want to win this game.
Come on, stay focused there because I'm just thinking about the combination between the Voyager and the Invader, which is the best combination in a score match right now. But unfortunately, this combination has a main weak spot because the Invader and the Voyager will go out from your defense.
Nice to my opponent.
They will go out of your defense. This is why it's very important to use a commander, a guard, or a protector in front of your defense as a CDM.
And look at, I'm amazed by the fact that Bertini has a lot more brain than the Voyager when it comes to passing it. He didn't try to force any kind of dribbling without any... Okay, I will go for it. I don't care. I will go for the jet. This is what the jet has to do. He has no brains, but he can run.
Now
he's in an offside.
Oh my god, jet with no brain.
Jet with no freaking brain. I hate you, Jet. But okay, I should have been more attentive there to the offside trap. But other chances did I have? Come on, Jet. No brain.
It's a free kick. It's a free kick because of the Jet. I told you to replace the Jet, Cosmin.
No.
Not fun to play with the Jet in these conditions.
Should I? I should have used another intruder or something on the sides.
Yeah.
Or even the gate crusher would have been better than the Jet. Okay, guard will now try to pass it again to the freaking jet. Okay, I will send it not to the jet, but to the poacher, who will...
Now maybe to the jet.
No, nobody. It seems my attackers, apart from Jebe, they are lacking some brains today, unfortunately for me. But this is the game, you can't do anything about it.
Mm-hmm. And don't forget about the poacher, because its behavior is not constant. This is why there are moments when he's coming back and then passes.
My opponent using 3-5-2, doing it really good, but I was... Oh, come on, game. What the heck, game?
You still can control the game. You have to make an interception right now.
Yeah.
And yeah, it was very, very close.
Their players are really looking for the best opportunity to pass it on the sides, and now he's gonna kill me in the air because he has their speedster. No!
But it's a save.
How the freaking hell... How was the speedster... okay, opponent, how was the speedster hitting the ball between a protector and the invader, the speedster with 20 height? This is unreal. Okay, this is... Okay, the idea was to test if the invader is good in defense. I would say he's good in defense, but
yes,
he is not as reliable as the Voyager. Do you agree, Madeline?
Yes, I agree, but I have to mention that I love the...
Madeline, wait. It was the Major and the Protector in defense marking a speedster. Major.
Okay, let's forget about this. So it's very important from my side that the Voyager is better than the Invader overall.
Yes, yes.
But as a combination, they are the best defenders in the game, trust me. But
totally
with the
agree.
Weak
totally
spot,
agree.
which I mentioned in the previous part of the episode. So this was the episode, guys.
And the Jet... out of the team forever. Jet, I don't want to see you again. I hate you. This was it, guys. Let me know down below why the speedster won the duel against my Major. And don't tell me that the cross was good. I know the cross was good because this guy knew how to cross. But it shouldn't be possible that the freaking speedster can overtake a Major in the air. If you've enjoyed this video, don't forget to leave a like, a comment, and a share. Subscribe to this channel for more content of a lot of games. And until next time, guys.
See you and bye-bye.
Bye.